And we're back with Tee Time Disc Golf. This is Steve Bro at the Sellersville Fishbowl 2018. Devin Frederick is with me doing commentary again. Devin?
Hey, how's it going, everybody? Welcome to the 2018 Fishbowl.
Yeah, so we're going to be playing the short tee boxes in the first round. The next round, obviously, we'll see a little bit longer of a layout. Now this should be, we should see a lot of birdies in this round, seeing as how we're playing the shorter of the layouts. And you're right, you can take either the big hyzer around this guy, you can play a flex shot at the middle. I think that most of the pros are going to be throwing a wide hyzer shot out and around. You guys,
and there goes Scotty
shaking hands, and Scotty running by thinking Kyle was playing tag with him. Here we go.
That tee pad was extremely slick.
Yeah, we have.
So I thought I was going to be better off by taking, you know, my allotted amount of distance behind the front of the tee pad, and still slipped.
Yeah, this tournament is run every year by Dustin Leatherman, part of being a TD is calling when things are too slippery and too wet, and he did allow play behind the tee boxes on some of these and gave these guys a little bit of a break. Andy showing you that Anheuser line just didn't get in the air quite enough.
Yeah, just needed it up a little more, having it flex out. So he's got a pretty wide open look. This basket does sit on a little mound. It's a little higher than normal. Me from 45-50.
And the wind was blowing just a little bit. I mean, it wasn't completely calm out there.
Kyle Bottmeyer getting stuck with the elevated basket too a little bit.
Yep.
But I think we're all cleaning up. Corey with a nice birdie. Cleaning up a par. So will Andy and Kyle.
Yeah, so this tournament, to give you a little bit of history behind this tournament, it's a benefit for a charity fundraiser for the Penridge Fish Foundation, which helps with hunger, and is just a all-in-all good community organization that's out there doing good things. And I know we raise thousands of dollars for those guys a year in a couple of different ways between the barbecue and the actual tournament. You got to give kudos to Dustin and Hannah for getting involved in that and making sure that the money from the tournament is going for the right cause. So.
Yeah, this is always a great tournament. A lot of volunteers.
Yeah, hole four, 290 feet, is one of those holes that, again, is going to play to an elevated basket, again. An interesting hole. It's definitely a turnover shot that you've got to get to flex the right way. I would assume that the big forearms can probably reach this basket.
Yeah. Well, you got to be wary of the OB to the right, and you can see it wraps around to the back, but that's pretty far back there. And yep. You can see the elevation going up a little more. We're taking steps up higher and higher here.
Yeah, even the long pin, you can see that behind is elevated as well. When this course was put in by a gentleman by the name of Jerome, he liked to elevate things and make things tricky.
Yeah, you'll see that throughout the day a little. Corey was trying to get that turned over and have it flexing out. He just got it a little too high, came out a little early, but he should be able to up and down and get a three.
And here you see the flick play from Kyle.
That was a great shot there. Getting it up in there, giving himself a chance.
Yeah, he's probably just at circle's edge, if not inside the circle, for that putt.
I'm going with my Mako. I, too, didn't quite turn it enough.
Yeah, just not enough turnover. But good little roll.
Yeah, give me a look.
Yeah, to give you an open putt at it. that these short tees are small, so most players are going to work off of the tee box and then run up onto it. But again, you can see where everyone is leaving it left. That is the safe play to stay away from that water over there on the right.
Yeah, because, I mean, there's still a bunch of trees between you and the basket if you end up in the water. All right, I'm probably just outside the circle. I was actually happy with where I was. I was actually almost level with the basket, being up higher on the hill. And felt comfortable. Mm-hmm. Kyle making easy work of it. He's a local. He's used to putting at all these different heights.
Hey, great two by Kyle. Kyle's one of those younger guys who came around quite a while ago and started playing, and you just see his distance increase, and he's a good player. He's gonna. We haven't seen everything Kyle has to give yet, for sure.
Yeah, he can definitely huck a disc.
Yep. There's Andy tapping in his par. And a nice little shot of Kyle getting his deuce. So we're going to be moving over to hole number 5, which if there is a hole that you look at and you say, okay, it's time to birdie, this is the one, because it's a putter shot just right at the basket.
Yeah, as a right-hand backhand player, I'm just trying to put it straight out there, have it fall off to the left and be parked not too far. There's creeks only.
Yeah, it's 12 close.
12 feet behind it.
It is close. You've got to be wary of going deep, and at 205 feet, if you give anything extra to your shot, you may end up in the OB. So let's see if we can't get a few birdies here.
Yeah, like you said, this is one of those that you walk up and you feel like you have to get just a straight putter shot. And early release out of Kyle. At least it kicked into the fairway. Easy up and down.
And here's Corey. Corey is really accurate. And a great kick for him.
Yeah, you should be able to make easy work of that.
Yeah.
Going with my XT whale.
Very good shot. Right.
Just using the wall and the tree.
Andy can't be happy about that.
There was a group putting over on hole 3, which wasn't too far away. He ended up backing off and going again and kind of got a little worked and iced by another group. And
Kyle just putting it up there close to the basket. And let's see if Corey can convert. Yes, he can. Now, Corey is interesting. Corey is one of the smartest individuals that you'll ever meet, and just spent a lot of time in Costa Rica working on his career. He actually works with amphibians and such, but man, I'm glad to see him back, and he's excited to get back into the disc golf thing.
Yeah, so. It's fun hearing all the real names for nature.
Yeah.
The genus and the species of everything. Oh my gosh, he knows it.
He blows your mind, so. Wrapping up your 2 here, and Kyle's going to tap in his 3. So that gets you under par, and I'm sure that at this point you're saying, I wish I could be a couple more under par, but it's time to get on the train.
Yeah, I mean, 3 and 4 are definitely not the gimmies out here like that one was. I know, you know, probably not going to birdie them all. Yeah. I would have liked to get off to a faster start, but it's first round, first thing in the morning.
Yep, and like I said, these holes are reasonably short, so you kind of feel a little less pressure when you're stepping up to some of these.
If you can get a bunch of them, you're doing all right.
Yeah, and this is very similar to the last hole with just a straight putter shot. I mean, that's all you're trying to do is throw a straight putter shot.
Once again, we got the elevated basket.
Yep.
And I actually tried to go with the soft Mako shot.
This is one of those holes where I've seen people get reasonably close and feel like they have to make that putt, and then they're putting back and forth because of the elevation on this thing. So certainly not, you know, one to take lightly. You want to get it. You want to get it really close off the tee.
And went a little long with the Mako. once I got up to it and I saw it, I was like, oh, I guess it was a putter.
Yeah. Yep. But not bad. I mean, you left yourself circle's edge, if not inside the circle, just a touch long. And Kyle playing that Anheuser shot, and that'll be a good look for him.
And that might be his mercy, I think. He's sponsored by Latitude. He catches the manhole.
Ooh. Yeah, Andy's deadly with his putter. I mean, he is definitely. That's one thing about Andy is when you hear a clap coming from the woods somewhere, you know he just made a good one.
You and when it comes from
you, you know you missed. Ah, Corey, clip that branch. Kyle sneaking it up and in there. Good putt out of him.
He's doing good.
Yep.
He's playing it like it's his home course. He knows what he's doing out there. He's confident.
Yeah, Kyle's played this course a lot, that's for sure. So we're going to be moving on to hole number 7. And hole number 7 is there's a walking path that's OB behind the basket. There's a parking lot on the right that is for the Little League fields. Really shouldn't come into play at all. There's a good chance that if you do throw something strong, you can reach that OB behind the basket. But again, this is Pennsylvania golf. This is, even though it's a short little hole, it is extremely tight. And there's not very many options on getting to this basket.
Yeah, you can see the pink flags to the right. That's actually a black net that was put up to keep you from going that way to avoid going into the parking lot where people park. There actually used to be a net on the left side, too, that they have taken down to open up a flick hyzer lane or a turnover lane,
right?
As well as the tight up the middle lane.
Yeah, there were a couple of trees that they lost on that left-hand side that kind of opened up that flick hyzer as well. I've tried it. I'm still going to go straight down the middle.
Someone always was taking it, and I would watch it, and I'm like,
Yeah, it like, looks very appealing.
Not when I'm competing. That's the only shot I've thrown is the one right in front of me.
Yeah.
So here we got Kyle. And just a little early release. It's a tough up and down when you hit early, too.
Yeah, I mean, for the distance on this hole being under 200 feet, really, I mean, there's no reason why you can't stand still and throw a shot up that gut. And but you managed to work it out.
Well, yeah, that was just the whale again.
And here's Andy. Let's see if we can... Yeah, I mean, you can see the jail. You can see how tight it is. It's extremely difficult to get something all the way up to the basket.
Yeah, it's not one you're probably going to hit every time, but you feel like you should.
Yeah, and this is one of the holes that the shorter tee box almost feels more difficult than the longer one, because the longer tee, you actually do have a couple of different options to go with, whereas the shorter tee, you're forced to play one shot. So you can see, I mean, for a hole under 200 feet, to not have as many birdie putts as we should here is pretty...
Oh, man, he just spit out.
It was a little bit left side, but it could have been...
It was low.
It could have been a little more gracious, yeah.
A little softer, it might have stuck.
But you pick up a birdie. Yeah, which is good.
Corey just tapping in. Same with Kyle. And after the unfortunate spit out, and he'll be tapping in for his 4.
So yeah, certainly you don't want to lose one on the field, which Andy probably feels like he did on that short little hole. And now we move on to hole number 8. Hole number 8, the basket location is directly in front of you. But again, it is tucked right next to the water. That's a common theme we're going to see here a lot.
Yeah, I mean, it's probably under 10 feet to the, and it's downhill.
And
so
there's
it's playing faster than that. I mean, if you run this putt and miss it, putting at that OB.
Yeah, you have a low ceiling. Yeah, and you have a low ceiling down the middle of this fairway, too. So with about 150 feet left to this basket, you've got to keep it underneath these trees. Most people are going to opt for a fairway driver.
Yeah, that's what I do. Just low, a little faster. Just kind of just only throw it at like 70%. Just a nice, slow, controlled shot with a fairway driver. I mean, I can get there with the mid-range, but...
Yeah, you've got to throw a really good mid-range shot, though, and kind of really hug that upper tree line.
I hugged that upper tree line for sure. I wasn't sure if it was going to hyzer in time or not. But.
And you have a tricky putt with where you left yourself, but...
Yeah, 30-footer or so.
Kyle, and that's the common miss on this play, I think, is to throw it too low, trying to avoid that.
Because, I mean, there's always the chance you kick to the left and go into the OB pond or the OB creek, so...
And that's the problem with throwing it too high, is that you definitely are going to hit that the tree line up there.
And you got an over on it. Ends up a little right, but he didn't nick a tree. He's going to have a... I don't know if he'll have much trying to putt over that bush.
Well, he might be able to straddle out, and at that point, his disc is moving the right direction to keep him away from the OB for the putt, so he may be able to get aggressive with it. Kyle with a really good flick there.
Yeah, nice little touch forehand.
Oh,
Corey
wow.
Gave it a little bid.
Yeah, very surprised.
He wasn't putting directly out the water.
Very surprised that he gave
it
a run.
Here I am putting directly at the water. Probably just inside the circle.
Great putt.
And yeah, that one felt good to get.
Yeah. A little slow
motion
action.
The first real putt I had to make with danger.
Oh, yeah.
But yeah, Andy had not much to work with. A little elevator putt of some sort. And it actually almost went in off that tree from the angle we were looking. It almost caught the top of the band.
And a par for Corey. And everybody else is going to tap out here and get their par. So we can... the one thing about Sellersville is that typically you're going to end up in the water at some point. Make sure you bring a towel in your bag.
And the other thing about Sellersville Fishbowl, hole 8... Kate's snack stand.
Oh yeah, that is one of the greatest things ever. Is
this always my favorite part of the fishbowl? And what made me remember that is I saw Corey's little brother in the back with his bag. Him and his brother's stuff bag so full, it was funny. Yeah.
So they've got a table out there next to the tee box that has dried fruit and gummy bears and just anything you can think of to snack on. And they put out little sandwich bags for you to fill up a little trail mix and keep on moving. And they also have a hot dog stand set up on the temporary hole area.
Yeah, so it's a lot of volunteers, well-run tournament. But hole 9, little uphiller, short, putter shot, just trying to throw it straight up there.
Great shot. Inside the circle, you've got probably 15 feet or so to the basket. And there he saw another disc come flying in from the other tee box.
And yeah, this pin location, can't quite see the basket, which makes it hard to judge kind of how far to throw your putter up there.
Kyle left another one left. He's early releasing just a little bit, and Corey got a great kick off of that tree.
Yeah, he could have been in a lot worse situation.
Andy with a great looking shot.
Parked.
And that's how you draw it up. It is it's a pretty easy just hyzering, natural hyzer for a putter right up that hill in that left-hand location. You definitely walk away upset if you don't get the birdie here.
Yeah, this is when you walk away feeling like you missed one.
Yeah, Kyle with another good touch flick shot. Guarantee Corey gives this a run.
Ooh. Hits the lock.
Yeah, just a touch short.
Just topping in my birdie.
See, you got to feel like you're rolling a little bit here.
Yeah, I'm starting to feel comfortable. Still early in the first round a little bit, just starting to catch my groove.
Yeah, that last putt, though, kind of set things in motion, I think, making that with the water in the background and the riskiness of that putt.
Yeah, definitely, yeah. It set the tone for, all right, I can do it. Yep. Just put it in there.
Yeah, because we're about to see the next couple of holes here are very much like everything we've seen so far, and it's just a nice putter shot, straight as you can throw it, and you're going to end up with your birdie. So you're sitting at four down. We've got Kyle at two down and Corey at two down. Time to get some separation on the card for you.
Yeah, I mean, like you said, straight up here, I actually go with the forehand. This is a hole that has changed drastically in the past, since last year, I think. Yeah, there's actually, you can see the railroad track back there, a chain derailed right there behind that basket, and it was full of butter. So this is a butter hole.
This is the butter hole. But that basket used to sit on that train track hillside.
But yeah, actually, I thought I threw that a little too hard, and I guess I just hit from right under the basket.
Yeah, you skipped to circle's edge deep, but that was a really good shot. And here's Andy going for an ace run there. Very nice.
Yeah.
And Kyle's got a good flick, so this is definitely a hole that sets up nice for him.
I think that's a rhino.
Just textbook. And a really good shot.
Corey just going with a putter. That was not Corey.
Oh, wow. He hit the stake to that tree, and it kicked him right there next to the basket, which is good.
Andy with a good look. And, yeah, I definitely don't put those past Andy ever.
No, that was a great putt. Right in the heart of the change there.
Yeah. Longest guy that far setting the pace for the group.
Yeah, good putt.
Sneaking it under the rim.
Yeah, a little bit high, but pro side.
Yeah, the elevated baskets, you never know what height they're going to be, so always making sure to get it up.
And a good two out of Corey, too. Looks like we're going to have a nice star frame walking away from this hole. Which, when you're playing as an open player, that's what you expect, is for everyone to step up and get this one.
This is one of the more open holes. You can see the whole second two-thirds of this is wide open for the most part.
You hit that initial gap and you're fine.
You're out in the field and you might not have a putt, but there's nothing stopping you from upping and down.
This is the gauntlet on the course. This is definitely the tightest fairway that you have to play through. The basket is actually tucked on the left-hand side down here on this green, and it is right on the water's edge. You have some small railroad ties there that separate and block any shots that are going to be going towards that water on the right-hand side. But you have to be careful on this hole.
Yeah, those aren't high. They're just kind of there. If you are nestling into that mulchy area, you will slide and catch, but
yeah,
I mean, they're only 4 to 6 inches.
And you're throwing your red whale.
Yeah.
Boy, that's a great shot.
It's what was working. Kept going with it. Andy.
It's a really good looking shot too.
Yeah. I'll have a look. But he's putting at the water, so.
Yeah, you can hear the water running in the background. It is literally right next to the basket. And Kyle overcompensating from early release syndrome and ends up on the right-hand side.
Made sure to commit and committed a little too much.
Corey did the same thing.
But that's a tight lane. I mean,
this is a hole that you don't expect everybody to get. Oh, no.
And there's an example of when the boards aren't catching. Another touch forehand out of Kyle.
Oh, it just clipped something and it's going to leave him short, which means that he's not going to have
a tough putt.
Yeah. And smartly just plays it to the left-hand side. He knows he's got 10 feet to the basket from there, so.
Yeah, he was running it. He just a little low release because he ended up under a bush where Andy.
Great putt inside the circle there. That was fantastic, but that is so dangerous with that water right behind there. And Corey's going to clean up his four. He obviously touched the tree as it was going into the chains.
Cleaning up the birdie. Kyle's going to do his par.
So how many birdies is that in a row for you? What did you just do?
I don't even know.
Four or five.
That's five in a row.
It's a good streak to go on because these holes are tricky. I mean, you're off just a touch on some of these holes and it doesn't necessarily work out the way you want it to.
Yeah, I typically play the back really well out here. Whatever it is, I can find myself getting on a streak in the back.
Well, the back is a little bit more open, and you do have to have a little bit more power. Not necessarily in this first round from the shorts. In the second round, you're going to see more of an impact on the back nine because it does play a little bit longer, especially through holes 14, 15, 13, 14, 15, those holes. But again, this is one of those controlled shots. This is hole 12, 235 feet. It is a par 3. It is on the right-hand side, which is a very difficult turnover shot. A flick is the preferred play here because as a right-handed player, what you're afraid of is hitting this hillside and just watching that disc roll right into the water.
Yeah, because, I mean, that basket is right on the hillside. This footage isn't really doing it justice, but if you hit that on the anisar angle, you're definitely going in the water.
With another good shot.
Yeah, just beat up AVR, making sure I was up high enough and right enough to not go OB.
Andy going the straight at it line, so that was a great shot, but he didn't want to play any type of ante on that. He'd rather go straight at it and just let the disc finish flat, which is really smart.
Yeah. Nothing wrong with it. And Kyle Bottmeyer, this is a T-bird that I actually
got. Don't do it. Yep. And you can see what I mean. As soon as it hits that rock bridge, it just wants to funnel
just
right to the
end of the water.
Yeah. And Corey's going to be safe. Yeah.
Yeah, nothing wrong with that. Can at least save par.
Even the sup shot is tricky, though.
Yeah, he did great.
That chains in the background sounded like he made it almost. So Kyle trying to save his three. Does not like it. And here we go. Let's salvage this a little bit. Yep.
Yeah. Good composure.
Mm-hmm. Easy two for you. Easy two for Andy.
Yeah, six in a row. Coming to the basket in the sky.
We've got Andy and you birdieing. That puts you down to seven down. So through 12 holes, that's pretty good. Can't really complain much about that. You picked up the pace and got yourself back on track where you would expect to be, and I think everybody would expect you to be. But as you can see, we move on to a 310-foot hole that is just unbelievably difficult. Actually, it's shorter than 310 because we're playing the short tee on this as well. So you can get out there and you can literally put it underneath the basket and still have trouble making it in.
Yeah, I mean, this one's so high and you can see it's up on a mound. And the rim of the basket is probably almost 6 feet high.
There is no safe place to be if you don't make this putt. I mean, you literally, it can roll away in every direction off of where it's from, where that basket is sitting.
So, yeah, I'm going to make it. I'm just trying to throw it into the side of the hill and then see what I get.
Yeah, it's crazy. I mean, you've got probably 16 feet of elevation up just to make that putt.
Yeah, and like we were saying, I actually do just throw it on the side of the hill, so I don't have to deal with that almost straight up and down putt.
And Andy's going to be down in that little bowl that's right there, which does not make for a very easy putt either. I mean, when you're close, you hope that you can make something inside the circle, but boy, it stresses you out every time you're putting on this basket.
And yeah, he'll be putting off the steeper end of this basket too from where he is.
Right, exactly. He misses the putt and he has more of a chance of rolling away another 40 feet and then having to come back again at it. And church bells ringing for Kyle. Come on.
I'll have a look.
Yeah.
Let's see if Andy can convert. Little right side.
Yep. Great putt by Corey.
Yeah, a little closer, but you can see how high up that is. Fortunate.
Yeah, that was close. Great putt by Kyle. He's got to be happy walking away with his birdie here. And like I said, you and Andy are so close here that it is not a gimme for you guys to get these in.
No, putting so straight up, it's a small window to have to hit. So, yeah, I try and do a little butterfly putt. And I could probably do the same, just trying to clean up our close par misses. One of the more stressful ones.
Yeah, he doesn't even know what to do.
And then he bug gets, in the eye.
It's like worst case scenario.
Great timing.
Did the same thing you did. And you can't even
get
the disc out.
I can't get that out of there.
Yeah, let's see. Okay, here we go. Hey. All right, well, let's clean it up, boys.
Yeah.
So that's going to conclude the first part of round one. Coverage. We'd like to give a big thank you out to Dustin, all the volunteers. Eagles Wings. I mean, there's so many people that make this tournament happen. Lunch.
Yeah, lunch provided one of the local churches. Hot dog stand. You can get a hot dog on your walk to the temples. You'll see later on the course.
So again, thank you to everybody. Tee Time Disc Golf, you're the best. We will see you guys on the next nine.
Like and subscribe. Tee Time.